On World Environment Day, a book was released on the mammals of India. Rohan Singh spoke to the author. Let's listen in.
What is the idea behind this book?
The idea is very simple. We need to interpret what we have, our natural heritage of this country, to our younger generation. If we don't even do that with mammals, which is the most visible, largest things that are there in this country, then where do we start? Remember, even mammals, when I was in school, there were two species of elephants in the world. Now there are three. So we don't even know anything about our mammals. When I first started work on this book about 10 years ago, we thought there were about 350 species of mammals. Now this book has 423 species of mammals. And if you go up to subspecies level, there are about 800 subspecies. So whether it's a bat or a rat or a whale or an elephant or a tiger, you'll be able to identify it and know something, some basic things about it when you're in the field.
What attracted you to write a book on mammals, and why only mammals?
Yeah, it's a very good question. I mean, I'm actually a bird man in terms of training. After which I was always been fascinated by elephants. So I spent a lot of my time writing about elephants, studying elephants and working on elephants. I went to this publisher to do a book on elephants. And that's when the publisher told me, elephants is all right. Why not do a broader book which covers all mammals? And because I work on large mammals myself, I said, but I don't know anything about rats and bats. So we should find some other professor. And I think for many years they chased other people whose names I had given, but nobody was willing to undertake it. Because the only book that was there was Pater, 1947, an Englishman who had written, and there's nobody in independent India who had attempted this task. So I think I was the only one who decided to take this rather gutsy thing forward.
So to write a book like this is not an easy job. It requires a lot of
money. Say that again.
But you're a decade, I think.
Yeah.
Tell us something about the process of writing and some experiences that you came across while writing the book.
So three things. I mean, one is, as I told you, when I finally said yes to the publisher, I said I need three editions to make it perfect. Yeah. So this one is number two in 10 years, right? A completely rechanged book. And probably there'll be one more by the time we know more about our smaller animals. So it's a continuous process of evolution. So that's one. Second, this is not just my work in a way. I am the interpreter, I am the sutradhara, I'm telling the story. But there are many young researchers and field biologists who have been working on many species across India. Also, there are more than 100 photographers who have contributed their images to me, and for this book, gratis, without taking any money, and I must be very thankful to them that this is a joint collaborative work that way.
In India, we have a rich variety of species. Unfortunately, many of them are on the verge of extinction. Some of them are endangered. Now, we have this whole debate going on, development versus environment. How vulnerable are these species, many of them, to these threats?
I think many of these species are vulnerable anyway. We have 1.2 billion people. Because of that, they're vulnerable. Now you want 10% or 9% economic growth, therefore they are vulnerable. We have one third of the world's poor in this country, therefore they are vulnerable. So they are vulnerable because of many reasons, not just one. But today you heard the Minister of Environment and Forest, Mr. Javadekar, say that he's not a pessimist. He said, I am an optimist. So am I. So I think if you do positive karma, if you do positive work, most of these can be averted. In India we have the optimism, the technological knowledge, and to some extent the ecological knowledge to be able to avert some of this.
When a species is lost or become extinct, millions of years of evolution also goes in vain with it.
Yeah.
In India, how much do we know about our species? Are there still some species which are still unknown, and is there a need to do more on finding them?
Fantastic question. Just with my book, two reports of the Zoological Survey and Botanical Survey were released today. One was on the new discoveries of botany in this country, and one is on new discoveries of zoology. Both had over 100 pages. In 1 year, they have discovered 100 more species of animals, small animals, and bird. So we have an encyclopedia of ignorance to guide us. Frankly, despite 5,000 years of civilization and some sort of protection, we still don't know. We need much, much more focused research and naturalists as well. Not just research. Today, our photography community is very active. Let them go out and find new species. You don't need a great scientist to take a good photograph. Let that come on citizens' forums. Then the scientists can look at it and say, hey, this looks something different. Then they can do further research. So every citizen can contribute to these sort of things.
what's your next plan? Are you planning to write on other birds and other things also?
Well, not birds. My next one will be on habitats, which will include habitats for mammals and birds and everything. You know, the idea was earlier National Parks and Sanctuaries book, but I said it should be more than that. It is where wildlife survives. It could be a national park, it could be a sanctuary, it could be a community reserve, it could be a thing that traditionally you have been protecting as a sacred grove, or it could be a place which nobody knows of, but yet has wildlife. So I'm trying to identify the top maybe 500 or so of such places, and hopefully in another year or so that book will come out to be a companion volume.
Your book is a wonderful record of some of the, I mean, species that we have.
Yeah.
Is there a dearth of such literature in our society?
I think so. I think in bird books we have done a good deal. I think there are a lot of bird books of birds, probably because there are a lot of bird watchers in this country. But mammals, which includes the tiger and the elephant, to think that before this book has come out, the last one was 1947 by Prater means there's such a big gap. Yeah, and people have not been writing. And most certainly, we have seen a few books on trees coming out, Pradeep Krishnan's books, which are very, very good. People have to do this on butterflies, flowers, so many other things.
Maybe, sir, one of the reasons can be that writing such a book requires a lot of effort, a lot of resources, and only some big institutions, some big sponsor, or a passionate person like you can write this. So how to break this? I mean, how to make people more participate in this?
I mean, the third part, the passion must be there, right? I have no big sponsors. Yes, I have a large, big institute, so there are boys and girls in that who gave me help, most definitely. But I think there's a passion and your focus, and if people have that. Salim Ali, when he started, didn't have a big sponsor or big institute, and he recreated the world of birds for India. So you should have that single-minded focus and passion that at least for this particular thing, next 4 years, I will do nothing else but that, then we'll get it out.